Dear students, now we are going to derive the capacitance of the coaxial cable.
Capacitance of coaxial cable. Coaxial cable is also known as leaders. This is the front view and this is the side view of the coaxial cable. Here we are having the radius of inner conductor is A, radius of outer conductor is B. Epsilon R is the relative permittivity of the dielectric material used in this coaxial cable. We are going to find out the capacitance of the coaxial cable at a distance R, which is in between this A and B. Generally, we know that capacitance formula is Q by V, correct? Yes, but here the cylinder is, the coaxial cable is a cable which is having certain length. So we are going to consider the capacitance charge in terms of charge per length. So we are going to consider one unit length. So this is very important. In case of coaxial cable, instead of saying Q by V, the capacitance can be denoted like this, Q by L, that is charge per length, per unit length for this cable divided by V. So charge per length is nothing but line charge density rho L. So capacitance can be defined for this coaxial cable as rho L by V instead of Q by V, because the unit of the capacitance is farad, we know that. But for this coaxial cable, we have to mention that as farad per meter. For that particular length, we are going to find out the capacitance. Do you understand the difference? So here, the unit of the capacitance for coaxial cable is farad per meter. That's why we can mention the formula as rho L by V. So next, as we already discussed, consider a coaxial cable of inner radius A and outer radius B. The two cylinders are charged at the rate of rho L. That is very important, right? Rho L means what? Line charge density. Particular unit length, we are going to consider the charge. So first step, by applying Gauss law, the electric field intensity at any distance R between A and B is obtained as like this. So this is, we have already obtained in our applications of Gauss law. Okay, so we can directly use this. So electric field intensity is equal to rho L by 2 pi epsilon R. This is what? That electric field intensity at any distance R between A and B in the coaxial cable. So next, the potential difference between two cylinders. As we discussed, we are going to find out the capacitance in between these two points. That distance is R. Correct. So here, the potential difference V is equal to, as usual, minus integral of E dot dr. Here the limits are A and B. Okay. So here upper limit is inner radius, lower limit is outer radius in the reverse order. So minus integral, and this E can be replaced by this value. So E can be replaced by rho L by 2 pi epsilon R into dr. Next step, we have to take this rho L by 2 pi epsilon outside. Okay, because this all are independent of this R. So integral of B to A to B 1 by R dr. So 1 by R means what? Integration of 1 by R is nothing but ln R. Correct. So natural logarithmic value. So ln of R, its limit is A to B. So next, we have to substitute that upper and lower limits here. So minus rho L by 2 pi epsilon into ln of upper limit A minus ln of B lower limit. So next, I am going to multiply this minus inside this. So this ln of A becomes minus, this ln of B, that is minus already is there. So minus into minus plus. So ln B minus ln of A. So we know that log B minus log A means what? Log of B by A. It is a division. So we can rewrite this like this, rho L 2 pi epsilon ln of B by A. So this is what? The potential. Now we are going to find out the capacitance of coaxial cable. Correct. Capacitance of coaxial cable per unit length. Since it is a cable, we have to find out per unit length. So we have already discussed capacitance is equal to rho L by V. So here there is rho L, you can write. And what is the value of voltage here? Voltage value is rho L divided by 2 pi epsilon into ln of B by A. Correct. So here rho L cancel each other. Then this 2 by epsilon goes to the numerator. So we can get capacitance is equal to 2 pi epsilon divided by ln of B by A. Its unit is farad per meter. Okay. And then this epsilon value is nothing but epsilon naught into epsilon r. Epsilon naught value, as you all know that 8.854 into the power of minus 12. This epsilon r value depends on the dielectric material. Suppose the dielectric material is air. Okay, we can consider the dielectric material is air, means in case of air, this epsilon r is equal to 1. At that time, this capacitance can be written like this. 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln of B by A. This is for air. Okay. So, this is very, very important formula. By using this formula, we can find out the capacitance of coaxial cable.